What a terrible topic to be discussing. We have seen this issue, though, rear its head before. In this case, though, we're talking about little children. I mean, just how bad has the situation become, particularly in Delhi?
Well, the situation is appalling, Michael, but it's not just in Delhi. We have to admit that paedophilia, rape of young children, is rife and an epidemic the world over. And we must not for one moment think that we are immune from this disease. It is, of course, utterly disheartening to hear of this news, but it is constant. And, you know, every time one case or two cases are suddenly reported, it's quite rare. There is a mountain of cases that go completely unreported and unremarked on.
And in fact, to that very point, the Hindu newspaper today said, quote, abduction and sexual victimization are the urban realities of the capital, and as you point out elsewhere as well. But it goes on to say, which constantly haunt every parent. I'm curious, in your looking at this issue, is there an underlying, in some areas, an underlying cultural issue that needs to be dealt with here, that these sexual assaults keep happening?
Yes, there is definitely a cultural, global cultural issue, and I call it patriarchy. I call it gender inequality. I interviewed, as part of my inquiry into the film I made, this journey, I interviewed a young man of 34 who had raped a five-year-old girl. And I interviewed him over 3 hours. He described in minute detail everything he did to this child. And towards the end of the interview, I said to him, please, I beg you, help me to understand how it is that you couldn't cross the line between wanting to do something like this and ruin a young baby's life, a baby girl's life, when you've described to me how wide her eyes were with terror, you've described to me how you had your hand over her mouth to stifle her screams, you've even shown me how tall she was and she reached to your knees. How could you cross the line? And here is word for word, Michael, what he said to me. And we should hear this message loud and clear. He said, looking at me as though I was from a distant planet for even asking the question, he said, she was a beggar girl. Her life was of no value. Quote unquote, I have it on film. It all comes down to that. If we accord no value to the girl child, well, of course men are going to go and rape her. If we have a system, a culture, in which we teach and program these men to think this way of women, we may as well simply give them a rapist's manual when they hit puberty.
That is just a sickening story to hear. You know, when I think back, there was so much outrage, and we covered it here as well, after the 2012 gang rape on the bus. It was the subject of your documentary. So much was promised by authorities. There was so much anger on the street. What happened to that rage and those promises?
Well, I suppose rage cannot go on, and it's actually a miracle and awe-inspiring and immensely admirable of the ordinary men and women in India who took to those streets that they went on with such tenacity and courage for over a month. It's miraculous. No other country in the world has ever done this. And from that point of view, India actually led the world by example. But you can't sustain that degree of passion, and it's very heartening to see people coming out onto the streets again now for these young children, this 2.5-year-old, the 4-year-old who had to have a colostomy bag fitted because she was ripped apart from vagina to anus and has died as a result.
You know, the other thing too is there's just so, you know, there's so many. Rape's a massive problem all around the world, of course, as you've said. But I think it's 37,000 rapes in 2014. One of the problems is it can take 2, 3, sometimes more years for the cases, when they are brought, to get to trial. So there's a problem with the system as well.
Michael, I'm so sorry. I didn't hear your question. Would you repeat it, please?
I was just going to say that there are tens of thousands of rapes, and it is a worldwide problem, but we're talking about India. One of the amazing things that I read is it can take sometimes 2, 3, or even more years to even get to trial. That's a systemic problem. It's a problem with the system.
It is indeed, and it's further evidence of how little meaningful focus and care there is for these cases.